After you have your prostate biopsy, the tissue will be sent to the pathologist who will analyze that under a microscope. If you are found to have prostate cancer, the pathologist will give a Gleason scoring of that cancer. This Gleason score is used to grade the cancer cells based on a scale of 1 to 5. 1 being slower growing, less aggressive, better differentiated, 5 being faster growing, less differentiated, and more aggressive. Pathologists will look at the 2 dominant areas of cancer on the slide and give a summary of those 2 scores. So typically, your Gleason score will contain 2 numbers added together to give a sum. Most prostate cancers will give you a score ranging from 5 to 10. 5 is more well-differentiated, slower growing, and less aggressive. 10, however, is much more aggressive cancer, poorly differentiated, and faster growing. The staging of prostate cancer is based upon several factors, including your Gleason score, your PSA score, and your TNM score. TNM refers to the staging system that is most commonly used. T refers to the size of the prostate cancer. N refers to the presence or absence of lymph node involvement. And M refers to the presence or absence of metastatic disease to other organs. T1 refers to prostate cancer that cannot be felt by digital rectal exam. T2 refers to cancers that are large enough to be palpated on rectal exam. T3 refers to prostate cancer that has escaped outside the prostate capsule or perhaps invaded the seminal vesicles where semen is stored. T4 refers to prostate cancer that invades other organs around the prostate, such as the rectum, the bladder, or the muscle wall. We will often group prostate cancer into low, intermediate, or high risk. Low-risk prostate cancer is men who have a PSA less than 10 and have a T1 or T2 disease that is a Gleason 5 or 6. Intermediate risk is in men who have a PSA between 10 to 20, a Gleason score of 7 or 8, or a T2 or T1 disease. Poor risk or high risk prostate cancer is men whose PSA is over 20, or they have a Gleason 9 or 10, or they are T3 or T4 staging.
Some prostate cancers are high risk, aggressive, and more likely to spread. Others are low risk, least likely to have bad outcomes. The biopsy says cancer, but current diagnostic tools provide limited information about how aggressive a man's individual disease is. So most men decide to treat prostate cancer immediately. Once treated, many men experience serious long-term side effects, like incontinence and sexual impotence. Immediate treatment isn't always needed. But right now, a man can't be sure if his cancer is the kind that is likely to require treatment or if he's okay to wait for now. What if there was a test that could determine how aggressive prostate cancer is? Genomic Health is developing a new test to do just that. By reviewing the underlying biology of the tumor and using genes from multiple biologic pathways, the test can predict the aggressiveness of prostate cancer when diagnosed, allowing a man to make a more informed treatment decision with confidence, taking care of himself with more information and greater peace of mind.